When it comes to animating characters, a good control rig is essential. Now you could build it all yourself, one bone at a time, or use an add-on that does a lot of the work for you. One of these is called Rigify, and it's actually installed with Blender by default. You just have to enable it. There are plenty of videos about Rigify, however, when it comes to attaching the eyes, most gloss over it or just skip that part entirely. So let's see how it's done. With the Rigify add-on enabled, use Shift A to add the main human meta rig. Then, within its object data properties, upgrade the face as required and generate the main control rig setup. For now, we can just hide the meta rig as it's no longer needed. With the rig now selected, locate the layers section in the object data properties, and while holding down Shift, left click on the small box for layer 30. This will display all the deformation bones that the rig actually uses to move your character. Let's have a closer look at the rig by going into edit mode and zooming in on the face. There's a lot on the screen, so first thing we can do is under viewport overlays, turn off relationship lines. Then next, using the N key side panel, under item rig layers, turn off the three face animation control layers. That has hidden a lot of the extra bones for now, so we can just focus on the main deformation ones. Focusing just on the eye, I've hidden the main head and jaw bone here as well, so it's easier to see. Each eye has three main deform bones: the deaf eye master, which moves the others when the whole head is moved around; the deaf eye bone, which lets you rotate each eyeball around to look in a direction different from where the head is looking; and the deaf eye iris bone that can be used to control the size of the iris. Now that we know what we are working with, let's see how to use it. First, we need a basic eye, so switch back to object mode on the rig and using Shift A, add a UV sphere. Then, using the N key side panel, set the X rotation to 90 and change all scale dimensions to 0.04. At which point, move the sphere up to the head, it doesn't need to be exact, and under the viewport overlays, turn on wireframes so we can better see what the sphere is doing. Now we want to align the center of the sphere to the main rotation pivot point of the eye bones. First, toggle on X-ray view so we can see where things are, and then turn on snapping. Click on the snapping options and select vertex to snap to, along with center for what we want to snap with. Then, with the sphere selected, press the G key to move it and snap it to the starting pivot point of the deform eye bones. Lastly, with the sphere still selected, press Ctrl A and apply the scale. Now it's time to attach the eye to the rig. If snapping is still on, that can be turned off. Then select the rig and change to edit mode. You will have to click a couple of times to select the deaf eye.L bone, and once highlighted, swap back to object mode. Blender will remember what is selected, which we are counting on for the next step. In the outliner, click on the sphere, our eye in this case, and then while holding down Ctrl, click on the rig. Then in the viewport, press Ctrl P and select bone to parent our sphere to the previously selected eye bone of the rig. Let's test to see if that worked. Turn off X-ray mode if it is still on, and with the rig selected, switch to pose mode. On the N key side panel, click on the face rig layer so we can see the main animation controls for the face. Then using the main eye common control, if we move it around, the sphere should rotate to look in the direction of the control. If we instead select the head control and start to rotate that around, the sphere will move with the whole head. Let's now try something a bit more complicated. Remember previously, when we looked at all the eye bones, the rig had a deaf eye iris bone. While it could be used for a few things, one of those would be to drive a shape key on the sphere. If the rig is in pose mode, switch back to object mode and then hide the whole rig for now. Selecting our sphere eye, we are going to add a very simple shape key. So in Object Data Properties, under Shape Keys, press the plus icon twice. First to add the base shape, and then again to add the shape we will modify. Then in Edit Mode, select the ring of vertices and double tap the G key to be able to slide them all outward along the connecting edges. Do the same again with the innermost ring of vertices. With that done, swap back to Object Mode, and adjusting the Value slider will now animate the eye. If we then set the min range to -1, we can now expand and contract the iris. With the shape key in place, it's time to attach it to the rig. In order to do that, we need to add a driver. So right click on the value property of the shape key, and from the pop-up menu, select Add Driver. If for some reason there already is a driver, or you move the cursor away, then just select Edit Driver. A second pop-up menu will appear, which at first could look a little scary, but we really only need to change a couple of things. First thing to do is to select exactly what we are going to use to drive the value of this shape key. So for the object, we select the rig, and then the Pacific bone. In this case, it is the deaf eye iris bone, with a .L or a .R for the left or right eye. With that set, we next need to decide which transform we want to adjust in order to change the shape key value. In this case, the one that makes the most sense is scale. So for the type, we select X scale and then local space, as we only want changes to that specific bone to control the shape key. You may have noticed the value then got set to 1. This makes sense, as if the default scale of the bone is in fact 1. However, we need it to be 0. The solution to that is easy. Just change the expression to be var minus 1. With that all done, let's test it out. Redisplay the rig in the viewport, and with it selected, go into pose mode. If we now select just a single eye control, instead of the full common one, we can move the whole eye around much like we did before. However, if we swap to the scale transform and scale the control circle in and out, the shape key value changes and the iris now shrinks and grows. That pretty much covers all the basics of how to set up a character's eyes with Rigify. If you like this technical overview and want to see more, or have specific questions or requests, then please click like and subscribe or leave a comment below. If not, that's perfectly fine, and I hope to see you for the next one. Cheers.